Yeah, send an invite. Come on, Turkey. Oh, boy. Yeah, I do agree with that. Home get to choose the jersey is a ways just have to wear the opposite, yo. I'm in favor for that.
That's not a basketball rule, my boy.
I agree. I agree.
We're playing basketball.
Well, tell that to Dallas, yo.
But the good thing is, it don't even matter, but I know my squad.
Okay. He know where his player is going to be at. Brian Dean scared to send an invite. Okay, I'll send it then. Don't worry. Damn. I ain't even waiting for it, yo. I ain't even get it. I'm just here, yo. Let's go. Let's go. We hyped over here. I'm just letting you know. Gotta. When is the NBA draft? Thursday. These kids' lives is about to change. They already changing now. Big cash, big
Hello,
cash.
everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on
Who your
EA
sleeper in the
Sports.
draft? Got a sleeper?
We've got a matchup where time of possession will be a focus. The Chiefs are top 10 in rushing yards, going up against the Raiders front seven that will need to
The
be
white
up
boy?
to the test.
Yeah.
All right, Larry, from one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. Nothing like
That's a
the
good
fanfare
sleeper, but
of
I'm pretty sure he
introductions to an
sleeping right now,
NFL
yeah.
game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the
You're
Oakland
damn right.
Raiders and the Kansas City Chiefs. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. On play action, they'll throw.
Oh, come on, baby.
There's one that's intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive, first interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts. Throwing here on first down. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Second down now after the incompletion. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Give him 15 yards on that one. Kansas City has a first down. Now, look, that wasn't a huge game, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. I know some of the talk after last week's loss was the O-line struggles. They gave up 4 sacks. He got hit here and taken down again, so that's something to monitor.
It is something to monitor, but they've got to help their offensive line out. Maybe a little bit different play calling, right? Draws, screens, get the ball out of the quarterback's hands quicker, maybe some quick game passes. All of that to try and help slow down a pass rush and make things easier on their offensive line.
And he's going to go down again.
Well, this is what happens when you get behind the chains, as people like to say. When you have obvious passing situations, hard to vary it up and fool a defense.
And you hate those situations if you're an O-lineman, right?
Oh, without a doubt, because you just know they're coming, and you never know exactly how. They can be exotic in their blitzes, or their athletic ability just takes over.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
All right, here we go.
Now back to throw. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense, 6 defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline. They keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing. The O-line coach will.
Yeah, last week in the loss, 5 punts as he gets this one away. This is taken at the 15. And, oh, a good hit there and knocked down hard at the 15-yard line. The Raiders offense now making their way back out onto the field. That opening drive ended with the INT. It didn't lead to points, but still not the way they were hoping to begin the game.
But how about going and telling your defense, thank you, a huge thank you. You said it didn't lead to points, stalled off that drive. Now they've got a chance to redeem themselves and maybe reward their defense a little bit by putting some points on the board on this one.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And some space here. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down. Counting down toward the midway point in corner one. Renfrey now. Oh, incomplete. The rookie had it and lost it there. And it'll be second down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And he's taken down, a Chiefs sack.
Partner, I know the ball security's preached like crazy, but every now and then you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was third and 10 versus third and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. Had to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
So we have to remember, this offensive unit, they've been off for the last 2 weeks. Had an open week, and so it might take them a little while to get back into rhythm. I know they worked hard to try and get past that in practice, but practice isn't game speed.
And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, and that could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it, he loses it, somehow the ball finds its way back to him.
But atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. Now they'll run it on the toss, and he'll find some space up to about the 25. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. And they're definitely showing blitz here. A handoff as they run the counter play. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. It's a loss of 2. Now third down.
Wow, that play got shut down in a hurry.
As soon as the snap came, you could see defensively they were just closing in. That was going nowhere.
Yeah, you count on your offensive line to give you a little bit of space, a little bit of time so you can make a move. There was none there for him.
Going right side here, and that's complete. And he is out of bounds, getting it just shy of the 35. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for them, too.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll get this up to about the 40. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. They'll drop to throw. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. That one goes for 24 yards. And the offense lining up 1st and 10.
Hurry up, here we go. Boo, landed. Leopard. No, 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 no. Jack, Patriots. Patriots. All right, now, lucky 56.
Ah! Now a handoff as they run left side. And some room to work. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Getting the sense, Charles, are going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. He'll drop to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a 2nd and 11.
Yeah, let's go.
One that's intercepted. Picked off at the 18. A big seam, and he might go all the way.
And
it's a terrific return here as he's going to have him set up with a 1st and goal right at about the 6-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. A great effort there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Raiders are able to cash in for six. And that makes it 7-0 Oakland. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is taken at his four.
Ooh.
Knocked down sideways right around the 26. The Chiefs offense now making their way back onto the field. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
This thing is everywhere.
That's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs. Yeah. So they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. A handoff as they run the counter play. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
This will be a two-yard loss on the play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
You tried.
Here's
it.
The Chiefs punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he gets this away, angled for the sideline with a lot behind it. Wow. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he's gonna be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Under 4 to go now as the clock runs, and they come up on second down. They'll look to throw. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And a big collision there as he winds up flat on his back. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down. Slot man moves right. On third down, he'll drop to throw.
Good shit.
Gets to him and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line. Chris Jones. In there to get him for a loss of 3. And it'll be fourth down. Here's Matt Bosher now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Taking on the midfield logo. A 39-yard punt, a return of 5, and the Chiefs will have excellent field position here as they take over. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. And last drive, 3 and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
they've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession, that told you just how starved they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to be run over. Hit hard as he'll be marked down at the 41-yard line. Pretty good little two-play sequence there. You force the incompletion, then a very short pickup.
Yeah, now maybe you bring in an extra defensive back or two because you want to try and defend on third down. They like to play those nickel or sub packages, don't they?
The Chiefs on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Going up top. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it. Well, their offense has struggled for sure, but they get the field goal here and at least get on the board before half.
And that's not something we should underestimate, because just getting points on the board can sometimes have a settling effect on a team, helps them start their comeback.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Raiders. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. They go play action here on first down. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down. Two minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Arrowhead after this.
Hey, Dean. You all right? All right. I thought you probably could have said you were sleeping. I want to make sure you said that.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
The pickup goes for 16 and a Raider first down. Back to throw now on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. Offense needs something here on second down. It is second and long. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he's going to be out of bounds but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
Little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. And the Chiefs are going to signal for and be granted another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Here's Matt Bosher now as he's on to punt for Oakland. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Now this is fielded in the end zone. We'll call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Chiefs are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10. And not great starting field position here for the offense. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9-yard line. Detroit. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half.
Here we go now.
Now a play fake here on first down. And down he goes. Brought down. Sack. The Chiefs will try and get to the line quickly. That's number four. Sack number four. They had four last week, so he's been down on the ground a lot.
Partner, they say the eye in the sky does not lie. And that's indeed the case because they watched the game tape from the previous week, incorporated into their own defensive scheme, and continued to get after this quarterback.
And now this defense will be searching for in trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. So we've reached halftime with the visiting Raiders out in front. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This is taken at his 4. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number 3. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. So we've got a 2nd and 5. Now they'll run it on the toss. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 15 yards on that one. Kansas City has a first down.
The more football I watch, the more I want to check and see if teams are going to panic when they're down on the scoreboard. And this team has shown no signs of doing that. A lot of the time, they come out after the half. Things haven't worked so well in the first go-around. They want to throw the football like crazy. But the way to open up throwing the ball is to run it. And they've run it well here to start the second half.
And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got 5 here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
So second and medium, second and 5 now.
Watch it now, body, body. I hear Leopard.
And the D looking like they may blitz.
Oh!
Room to run inside the 40. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. 31 yards there and a first down.
I know that play went to the left side, and that's what it was designed to do, an outside handoff there. But how about the whole offensive line being involved? Seal the left side where the play was going, what they call play side. But how about on the back side? Just taking care of business to make sure no one can get there and disrupt it.
Is the biggest key the left tackle?
Without a doubt. Control that edge. Get out there. You want that left tackle. If you bring your tight end over there. Either way, control the edge of the line of scrimmage. You got a chance to rumble.
No gain, and it's second down. So second and 10 here. Going to get this one down inside the 15. 9 yards on the pickup there as they'll be left with third and one.
Nice job there defensively on third down. Not only did they string the play out, but they didn't allow any room for a cutback. Really well organized on the defensive side.
The Chiefs on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. The gain of 5 that time gives him the conversion and makes it first and goal.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? Lava has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. First and goal from the 8. As they run the counterplay. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
And the 8th play on this drive coming up. Now they'll run it on the toss. And finding room to work, he's down to the 2-yard line. A nice run there, 8 yards, moves him much closer to the goal line now for third down.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
Defense likely bringing pressure here. And he's going to take it into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. A great play there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Chiefs are in for 6. Able to punch it in on third down. Makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a fourth down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating, will we have to make the call? They already had it lined up. Never even got to it.
Santos out now. He'll kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. So here comes the Raiders offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half 2.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of
the most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an open.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 44. And his these guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. Maybe he telegraphed it a little bit right there. You've got a cornerback knowing that he's going against a rookie quarterback. He stepped in and picked it.
You think he had a great week of preparation, looking forward to this opportunity? And the second part of that is, when you're a young quarterback, you are going to stare down targets. But oftentimes, your playbook hasn't expanded to give you full field reads as well. Makes it a little bit tougher for him.
Shit.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. And he returns it into enemy territory down to the 45-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
To the air here after the INT on the last drive. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Credit the secondary and credit the defensive game plan. They've been in his hip pocket all game long. They understood coming in that he was a big-time receiver.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And both guys were there, but it falls incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball.
Yeah, well, if you like the concept of the game but don't like that building shit, they have a free game called H1Z1.
And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Pug
the Raiders on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 10. Back to throw. Throwing the out route incomplete. That's Willis. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. That one good for 13 and a Raider first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get about 3.
Oh, come on.
28.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Here we go with 2nd and 7. They'll try a little trickery here on the end around.
Oh.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. Fake. They'll look to throw.
What the fuck?
It's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off at the 22. He's at the 40. The 20. 10. And he will score. Touchdown, Kansas City.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys who are picking it off, they're not saying that. What word are they using? It's OSCE. And that means catch the ball and go the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say OSCE.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
It's good to make it 17-7.
Yeah, I mean, Madden know what they want to do.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. And now here come the Raiders. And following the pick six, and they decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early and let him get settled back in.
But they told us they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
So it can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Well, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player? Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Second and 10. That's complete to John Ross. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Solid gain of 18 and a Raider first down. They'll look to throw here. He finds Ross right side. It's complete. We're back now in KC. It's Raider football here, but they're on the short side of the scoreboard right now as we begin the fourth. So here we go, first and 10 now. He'll look to throw. Over the middle, that's caught by Ross. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. That throw good for four. It's second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
And his throw is incomplete.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. The Raiders on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 17. He'll look to throw. Under pressure and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. It'll be spotted on the right hash. A 52-yard attempt. And he's going to miss this one. Wide to the left from distance. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, sent this one off target.
They run the counter now on first down. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And it'll bring up a second and 13. All right, here we go. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. picked off near the 42. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score. Well, don't change that channel just yet. This one may have gotten a bit more interesting.
Put down the remote, put down the clicker. This one looked like it was over. It looked like they were ready to seal the deal. But in doing so, by pitching it around a little bit, it cost them. We could have a great finish.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Chiefs offense, they get ready to head on the field. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. And to give this time to the tailback. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Well, Brandon, pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to get about 7 yards on that one, up to around the 33. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
This is third and two. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. They'll set up to throw. Flushed out right. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. It's a gain of three, and it gets him the first.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker.
Hurry up, here we go. Boom, nine.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Eluding the pressure right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. According to the head linesman, incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
So this is what happens when you throw interceptions. That confident veneer that you have gets chipped away a little bit. Maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, under throwing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Now back to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Here's the Chiefs punter now, as he's on here to punt it away.
Oh!
They,
I could have blocked it, and I missed it. Oh, you're so...
And the spot will be inside the 35. And now Oakland ready to take the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
That was so cute.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. A Raider first down, 17 yards.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Over, over, over. Detroit, Detroit.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
And they'll try to squeeze in one more play here before the two-minute warning.
Real shooter, thank you.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set.
All right, now, lucky 56, lucky 56. That's fine now, lucky 56, lucky 55.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play there, second down. Yards still left on second down.
Detroit! Detroit! Hurry up, here we go! Over, over, over!
On second down, there's the option going left. And holding it may be the wrong decision as he stopped in the backfield. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. The Raiders on third down. They've had their troubles. Just 1 for 6. This is third and 14.
All right, here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90. All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. No, 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 no. Check. Patriot. Patriot.
He'll look to throw.
Oh, you. Oh. Oh. How did he miss the throw?
Too much mustard there on that pass.
Hey, Chihuahua. Didn't they really come loose with that one? Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. It would have been a long field goal. The fake doesn't work out. Well, it was a long attempt to begin with, so the fake you might have known was somewhat of a possibility. Credit to the defense, though. They weren't fooled.
You're right, they weren't fooled. And they were in a position of having to play it both ways. Guard for the fake, but you still want to rush the kicker because it was a makeable kick. So they ended up getting the best out of the whole thing. Stuffed the fake, and they take over the ball.
Given 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. A handoff as they run the counter play. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Second down following the run. And he'll give it here to his running back. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. And now the question everyone's wondering, look at the clock, late fourth quarter, do they put the ball in the air here on third?
I don't. I run the football and I tell my offensive line, no leakage up front. I don't want my running back hit as I hand the ball off to him. I don't want any type of an issue. But if I am going to throw it, quick throw, out to the perimeter, maybe one of my best receivers running a quick slant or something like that.
Throwing for his running back and he's got him complete. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. A great effort there. His 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Santos out now. He'll kick it away. This is taken at his four. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Now the Raiders offense, they get set to head back on the field. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly. Then they'll take it from there.
And Charles, in this situation, this is where the word miracle comes into play.
Have to score real fast. Maybe throw a jump ball in the end zone and hope for the best.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground and it brings up third. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
The Raiders on third down. It's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Renfrey now. He's going to let it fly. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And that'll be just about all she wrote for this one. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. Getting down to the end here, they have a 2-score lead. Barely, but it's a 2-score lead. So that probably makes you as a coach feel a lot more comfortable right now, doesn't it, Charles?
It does, but it doesn't mean now you go out and run option or some kind of wild double reverse or anything like that. But you do know that if anything does go haywire, you're still in control of this game.
I want a double reverse, don't you?
I'm just waiting for that day where we actually see something like that in this situation.
We'll see what happens here.
Hurry up, here we go.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. That is caught inside the 5. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Trying to bust out of that losing funk, and these fans have to like this. And all right, fellas, this is more like it.
And I know that if this holds up after the game, They're going to give the fans a lot of credit being at home, getting the support. But you and I both know it goes deeper than that. They had to get it together in their own facility, look each other in the eye and say, okay, what's it going to take to break this losing streak? And they really came together with a good week of practice.
Santos out now. He'll kick it away. This one fielded at the five. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, Coach, what do you want to call? He just waved a hand like, who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. And Charles, you know
game,
what coaches
man.
Always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.
Exactly right. When you start a season, everyone's goal. Win all of your home games, split your road games, and you're likely going to be in the playoffs. But when you win at home, boy, what a great feeling that is. You don't even mind if people are at your house when you get home after a win like that.
So for Kansas City, the win will help them keep pace in the playoff race as they move to 6-3.